What's up, everybody? It's your girl, Steph Lover.
Your boy, P. Stu.
Once again, it's on. It's Hard Hats and High Heels, the podcast. Hashtag Hats and Heels. And we've been on this DMV wave lately reason, right, Stu Minotti?
Because, yeah, we on. DMV is on.
DMV is
DMV
lit.
DMV is litty.
Crazy. We got another artist, made it out the gates, rise to the top. The kid is coming, and he is coming with good company. Rock Nation is the label. Q the Fool is the artist. Say hello to Q the Fool, everybody. Well, hey, you can, but we can.
Hey, Q the Fool. I got.
Y'all know him, too. Y'all
can say something, too. Love, I got his name right, though. It's D.A.
Yeah, we had,
D.A.
We had a problem with Will the Rapper.
Will
you know
the Rapper,
what
I spelled
D.A.
And I spelled D.A. And he was like, who the fuck is
who
D.A.?
The fuck Will the Rapper. Is Will
my
the
bad,
rapper.
My bad, man. I got Q name right, though.
Yo, Stu, we done came a long way from Section 8 Mob. Nonchalant.
Question mark asylum.
And here we are with Q the Fool. I do believe the first DMV artist signed to Rock Nation.
Mm-hmm.
Are you the first?
I don't know for sure.
I think you is.
I'm probably one of the realest.
If not the first, definitely the realest.
Definitely the realest. Straight from Lago, you know what I'm saying?
Lago,
Maryland. I'm from New York, so it would be equivalent to what, Stu? Queensbridge, maybe?
Maybe, you know what I'm saying? Largo, more like, maybe like Jersey, like, you know what I'm saying? Like
Jersey?
The Jersey side, if you know what I mean, or Manhattan, but you know what I mean? Like
you tell us,
like
what's Largo like?
If you had to make a comparison, but it's really its own thing.
I don't know about New York. I don't know too much about New York. But Largo, like, it's like in the middle, it's like apartments, you know what I'm saying, condos, and like on the outskirts, it's like houses, you know what I'm saying?
Like Jersey.
So you get a little, you cross the street,
like
be in the burbs, come back across being dead in the middle of the hood.
So you could get both. So I seen everything. I seen people with money. I seen people dead broke. So I done seen.
I think people think when they hear Maryland, they think it's all nice and a lot of trees, you know what I'm saying?
I don't know. Shit, I done seen some real shit.
It's nice everywhere. It's rough everywhere. You know what I'm saying?
It get real everywhere.
I don't know why even people think that about other places that they don't know about. You know what I'm saying? Because it's nice and rough everywhere.
One thing I do know, Stewie, that anywhere there's a MLK Drive or a Malcolm X Boulevard, shit tends to get real around those parts. You dig?
You got to stop disrespecting King and X like that.
I'm making them up, actually.
We got to uplift them blocks, make them black, sprawling, urban, you know, thriving communities.
Yes, you know what he said so eloquently. You know what I'm saying? Hey, Q, so we know you from Largo, Maryland. You know, tell us a little bit about yourself. How you get into the game?
Because,
you know, we are in a predominantly go-go area.
I've been playing rapping. But then, like, I got locked up for attempted murder when I was 16.
No!
Not for real. And I came home.
I know
when I was
for real. You can't say no shit like that.
Nah,
it's not for real.
Cause these rappers be lying.
For real?
Nah, for real.
Damn, now I'm a little like, nah, for real. Some shit like that. I ain't nothing but a Google search.
Exactly.
Shit.
That's what they
these
do.
These rappers be lying.
They lie like shit. So that's when I got
I'm
locked.
Glad you made it about
I got locked
for
that when I was 16. I came home when I was 18, and after that, that's when I came like without came out with a mixtape. And like everybody was just eating it up. Cause everybody already knew me. I've been like to 5 different high schools. Like all type of middle schools.
You was really a goddamn fool. Now we get into the essence of the game. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I'm peeling layers
he made
over
it
here,
Manati. He turned it around.
I turned all that shit up though.
You know
I took that, turned it to this.
You go to 5 different schools, that's 5 different fan bases.
I went to 3.
You know what I'm saying? That's crazy.
They ain't know that.
Like, that's a plus. I'm thinking, like, my son, I might just send him to 5 different schools just to do it. Just to, you know
for
what
the
mean?
Culture,
that
Stu,
might
for
be
the
a
culture.
Wave
he
right
gotta
there.
Be lit. He gotta be lit.
He gotta be lit, but if, I might send him to 5 different joints.
So, if you was down from 16 to 18, was that your escape plan? I always say plan to work and work your plan. Was that your plan? Like, yo, when I get out of here, I'm not coming back here, so this is the plan to start rapping
really,
and whatnot.
Because when I came out, I was even wilder, and I got locked up.
That's usually
I got locked up a year. I got locked up a year later. I was rapping. It was just like it was juvenile. They sent me like by Pennsylvania.
Play.
Like, it was play. Yeah. Like, you know what I'm saying? We was out there playing, like smoking, like, you know what I'm saying? It was just fun. So, but that, you know what I'm saying? I ain't know that was a real jail. You know what I'm saying? That's why I crashed out when I was 19. I crashed out again. I got it. Then yeah,
that
again.
Shit got real, huh?
Yeah, and that's when I got this. But this time, I had made so many, like, it was just too much going on out here. And I went in there. I was just fighting. So I spent most of that whole year in the hole. Mm. You know what I'm saying? So
a lot that's of time I just, to think.
Yeah, so I had a whole lot of time to think. That's when I just came home, like, last year. That's when I was 20. I'm 21 now.
Wow.
And now all this shit.
All this shit happened in a year?
I got kids older than you.
Because Sneaker's older than him, goddamn.
Older than him.
Yeah, I'm 20. I'm 21. I just turned 21 March
4th.
It's
crazy.
March 4th, you just turned.
Yeah.
So this is all, like, perfect timing for you. That was a great birthday present to get signed to Roc Nation.
It's a blessing. It's a blessing.
How did that maturation happen? How you go from Largo, Maryland to Jay-Z's office?
I had a show at Bowie State, and it was Gucci Mane manager. He Muslim too, so somebody linked us up. We talked, we salam each other. Then somebody linked us up again. So he like, man, Q, like, he took interest in me. He like, man, let me work with you. Let me see what I could do. Let me try to just help you. I'm like, any Muslim, so I'm like, all right, bet, let's do it. So the first thing he do, he calls Zaytoven. He give me a Zaytoven on the phone, get Zaytoven, send me a beat. I knocked the beat out, I sent it to him, Zaytoven, like, damn, shawty like that. Send me like 30 beats, 40 beats.
Damn.
I knocked the tape out that week. I sent that joint back to Zay. That's when he like, oh yeah, we gotta shop a deal for this joint. And we just went around shopping deals and it turned to something way bigger than that. You know what I'm saying? They saying something way bigger than that. I ain't never had no hit record on the radio or nothing like that. You know what I'm saying? This all of people trusting my talent and seeing the realness in me, you know what I'm saying? And giving
real
me a chance.
That's real. That's a real statement.
You know that is real. And that's how now, so
we're in the numbers too.
And the numbers there.
Don't lie. People do.
So that's how the first project on the Roc Nation is going to be the Zaytoven.
Yeah,
by Zaytoven. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? The whole thing. You
you know how hard it is to get a Zaytoven beat? Yeah, exactly. He said you 30 of them?
Exactly.
Like, you think you got any of them lying around?
Speaking of which, Zay dropping his joint, Trap Holla Zay.
Yeah,
he heard Q was going to be up here, and I don't know what y'all be on, but he sent a couple bricks. You know what I'm saying? Like,
what he says, Stu?
I don't know what Zay and Q be on. But he said he heard Q was going to be up there. He sent a couple bricks up.
God damn it.
Pass me a knife real quick, man. I got to make sure this shit good.
You know what I'm saying?
I don't know what just happened, but I gotta let the people see this.
We
got to
make sure.
Out the blue in the middle of the podcast.
We got to make sure
this shit pure. Drop some bricks on Q from Zay.
Pass me the knife, man.
God damn.
He said it's pure
white.
Hold on,
we can't tell about that. That way.
You know,
that's
what I mean.
Crazy.
It's going down out here, man. That Zaytoven Cuba Food Connect
crazy.
Is real. You know what I'm saying? We definitely looking forward to that. To that project.
Ooh, you get a promotion for that shit.
Zay, that's all Zay. He dropped them bricks on us real quick.
Nah, for real.
Zaytoven, you know, one of the premier producers now in the game. You get a Zaytoven beat, you has definitely solidified. So a Zaytoven mixtape.
Yeah.
Kiddo.
Mm,
I'm glad we got you now, Stu. We got him. Got him. Early. Ha ha, bitches.
About to get a little harder to get this interview.
No.
Yeah.
But, but look, I really want to talk about your faith. You brought it up. I think that's important because a lot of people think, you know, you're a younger generation. Y'all just out here being assholes, you know, drinking, smoking, popping pills, whatever. Hey, you doing that? That's on you. That's fine and well. But the fact that you brought up your faith and the fact that it actually helped, you know what I mean? Because you linked with somebody with a, you know, a like mind.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, let's talk about that a little bit because I mean, just addressing him and him knowing that you was Muslim, I'm assuming that he knew somewhat of your character.
Yeah, of course. So, like, as far as, like our faith and, like, my religion, being Muslim, like, we all supposed to work together and help each other just, like,
They
thinking Muslims just carry around choppers trying to kill people.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? We really...
So
It's really a brotherhood. It's really, you know what I'm saying? We living by the sunnah. You trying to do everything as if the Prophet Muhammad would do. You know what I'm saying? But that's conversation for another time.
Right.
But,
I got you. Was that in your family or after? No, like, did something you picked up
during the cost? Yeah, I converted when I was in juvenile when I was 16. Yeah, that's when I converted.
I mean, work for Malcolm X. I'm not mad. Yeah. Everybody has to find their own journey.
You know what I'm saying?
You really don't really think or get time to think until you lock it up for real. You know what I'm saying? The best time I ever got time to think and really know who I am when I was locked up, I'm keeping on it. Like, when I'm out here, it just...
It's moving so fast. Yeah.
Especially if you really doing stuff out here. You're not really sleeping all day. I'm waking up. I'm getting straight to it. It ain't no time to think. Come on, going to sleep, getting up, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, like when you locked up, them times you gotta really know you gotta be 10 toes down and get your shit right. So when you out here, you don't fall back.
And I like that the youngins hearing this, you know, they can see one thing that's consistent with you is you taking things that might be negatives and turning them into positives.
Yeah. Going to the different schools,
being incarcerated, you know, all turning all those things around and bringing it full circle to where you are now, and now channeling those energies and that, you know, into this movement that you're doing musically. Mm-hmm. And I see the chains too. I see a Glizzy Gang chain
early.
And a Rich Shooter. Can you explain, you know, what and what's going? Because you know,
Glizzy. Is that Shy Glizzy?
Yeah, Shy Glizzy gave me this.
That's famo right there. Yeah. DMV thing.
That's just
thing.
A family thing,
yeah.
Y'all.
Yeah, that's some family shit. That's, you know, don't nobody do stuff like this. Right,
man. So usually, like, it's like you gotta sign that, like, this, contract, like this, or
like what we doing, you know, stuff like niggas doing out in Atlanta. We giving each other chains, like we about to bring this shit up. You know what I'm saying?
It's a genuine love there.
Yeah, yeah. Like we about to show these niggas like we can work together. Like this is how this shit supposed to be.
And see, being as though you might not even have been born yet when me and Steph started on the first started on the radio in DC on 93. This is the vision that we saw 22 years ago.
Yo, when I tell you, the area, they had no hip hop on the radio.
Not like this.
We literally used to have to sneak. Yo, it used to be to the point where if it was like a rap on an R&B song, they played the version without the rap. So during the rap breakdown, it was just music. We'd be like, what the fuck? You just gonna leave it like that? Like, we know there's a rhyme that goes there. Yeah. Like, who y'all fooling? But that's how, you know, anti-hip-hop it was. So now, it's a beautiful time because I can't even believe how much, like, trap music or, you know, it was even levels to getting on the radio having, you know, hip-hop music.
Yeah.
And now it's like, shit, you know what I'm saying?
That's all they play.
The label, the Rock Nations, those entities
they get it. Yeah,
of hip-hop, of the hip-hop industry are looking at the DMV, and looking at D.C., Maryland, and Virginia.
And that was, like, another thing with Rock Nation, because, like, I thought I was going to go in there, it was going to be, like, some label shit. Like, they're going to be like, you got to do this, you got to do this,
you got to do this.
Like, it's not like that.
They want you to be you.
They want me to be, you know what I'm saying? I'm doing it. Like, they ain't telling me I could do whatever I want to do.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
So that's what it's all about. And, like, I just needed another platform to take me where I need to be. Yeah. I could do this. I could go to clubs on my way all day.
Mm-hmm.
I could do this. I could be on the eco. I'm trying to be everywhere. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And that's the platform that
global
I needed.
Global.
And I still want to be able to. I still got Rock. I still got Rich Shooters. That's my label. You know what I'm saying? They not signed no deal. I still got
some
artists.
Business,
they
man.
They doing what they do. They got like 500,000 views. So like we doing a whole lot of stuff. It ain't just stopping just at Rock Nation. We still got Rich Shooters. We doing a whole lot of stuff.
Yeah, man. Big
Yo,
business,
speaking of
man.
The Rock Nation. So have you had the face to face with the man?
We ain't had the guy yet. It's coming.
Because if you have, you be having another chain hanging here. That's how you know when you're face to face with Mr. Kata.
Nah,
you dig?
Man.
He makes it so official.
It's coming. It's coming real soon.
I just know I've never sat with him in the capacity of being signed to his label, but we've sat with him on different occasions for interviews throughout his career, different points in his career. And I know every time it's gems and it's definitely going to be something for
like,
you.
And he has a crazy sense of humor that people don't see.
I link with Kaz Casanova, like, that's my man.
Yeah.
You know, he signed a Rock Nation.
Yeah.
Like, he already be telling me, like, man, I be, when I talk to bruh, Man, he be making me look at shit different.
Just don't stare at Beyonce. I heard that's the like that's the deal breaker.
That's not even fair, yo. How do you not stare at Beyonce? Just
you gonna have to practice that. You got no time stare, to use your peripheral. You little stare glance. Because that might be the deal breaker.
A little glance or something. Like, damn, Beyonce. Nah. She gotta get out.
You know what I'm saying?
I can't look.
Man. Yo, so let's talk a little bit more about the music, you know what I mean? Because that's why you're here. You got the mixtape dropping.
Mm-hmm.
Stu laid it on us crazy, you know what I mean? Zaytoven is coming. You on that Zaytoven, the trap project. He's all over your project. How is it working with, you know, such an iconic producer? Because at this point, yeah, that's where he's at with it.
At first, we were just talking on the phone. We ain't never meet. Like, we was talking on the phone, like, he like, man, you like he telling me like man, like you for like you for real. Like he telling me this over the phone, like mm-hmm. We ain't even face to face yet. So this was like for like a month or two. Then we got a tape and it was time to shoot the videos. So I flew down to Atlanta, linked with him, and everything was just natural. Like he came in the stool, chilled with me for 30 minutes, you know what I'm saying? Did it, like, he had to go do something. He called me like, yeah, Q, we all at? I'm about to pull back up. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He ain't have to pull back up. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? He in that joint chilling. You know what I'm saying? We chilling with everything. It's natural.
That's like, big. You yeah. know what I'm saying? Like, it could be just a lot of just put together stuff out in the
a lot
music
of just
game.
Business. Yeah. Just yeah.
People behind the
nah,
scenes.
Nah, you know what I'm saying? He pulling me up. He pulling me up, telling me how, you know what I'm saying? So... That's big bro for real. Like yeah. I can't do nothing but respect them, man, cause they giving young men like me a chance, bro. Like
that's big.
I ain't supposed to be here. I would be saying that shit. I ain't supposed to be right here for real.
No,
yes you are. Yeah, to
yes,
us.
Yes, you are.
I know what you're saying, but to us, it's like yeah, you right.
It's
where
a reason.
You're supposed to be.
You know what I'm saying? It's definitely a reason. Yeah. The spotlight is on DC right now. Maryland, Virginia area, and you're a big part of that. You
yeah,
know,
for
big
sure, for
reason.
Sure.
When won't you feel no pressure, no shit like
nah,
that?
Nah,
you
know never saying? No pressure.
Pressure
I don't never have no pressure on me.
Pressure make diamonds.
Yeah, of course.
You know what I'm saying? Like, just a little. Because, you know, it's a great responsibility that we all have, even us from a media standpoint, you from the artistry. Like, we got to put this area
and the
on
reason
it,
I believe so, really, is the go-go, like, in the essence. Because, you know, being from New York, everybody knowing I've been down here for a really long time, they... First thing that come to mind is go. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, yo, DC is so much more than that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, definitely, yeah.
That's that, but you know,
it's a whole culture down here.
Yeah, it's a
like,
whole, it's deep.
Like, and it's real legends down here. It's real gangsters. It's real niggas that was bred out. You know what I'm saying? Niggas different out this joint. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I play Rayful Girlfriend in the movie. You know what I mean? I still get peace to that. I don't fuck around. Phone calling this stuff. Shout out to Rayful, though. Yeah. It's my guy. But, yo, Q, we wish nothing but the best from you. I mean, Stu, you got anything else? Like,
I mean, what's coming
he's
up?
So
like,
cool
shows?
Shit.
When's the project? Is the first thing? Is the first record from the.
Yeah, not playing.
Yeah, they're not playing. Not playing.
We see his other video with the Shirley. He got an old soul, nigga. I was looking for that. The lumberjack with the hat to match and
okay,
all that.
Okay, okay.
Gucci Fresh. Hey!
But nah, they're not playing out. That joint out on YouTube right now, though.
Right.
That's out on YouTube and, The Honey Keys. Honey Keys dropped June 15th.
June 15th.
Any shows right now? I don't got no shows, man. Y'all gotta book me.
We got that get that fool tour going.
Yeah,
that Buddhist tour going.
What made you, like you said, Glizzy super independent? What compelled you to sign the Roc Nation?
I mean,
you know what I'm saying? Because you could have just stayed on the independent path and
personally, and I was just going through a situation like I had caught a case when I had just caught came home. So whole time I was thinking I was about to go back in again for real. Cause I was just on the box for like 6 months. Mm. But I just beat my I copped out the 6 months.
Mm.
And judge let me go. So like I just feel like I could have stayed right here, but I just feel like I gotta do a change. Cause that's the reason why I caught my case. Cause I came home, I had a whole lot of buzz. I was getting booked for Fillmore, everything.
Yep.
But I still caught a case. You know what I'm saying?
So you gotta get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, I mean not get the fuck, but
no, you know, I mean like
well, I gotta make a change.
Yeah,
I gotta boss up.
I mean, you from here, but I'm saying sometimes when you're different or you're trying to go places,
yeah,
you know, everybody like, don't want to see that. Everybody's not happy for you.
Like
you
it just got. I always like had in my head like. You just gotta change something up and it's gonna go a different direction. It gotta go. If you switch something up, it's gonna go. If I sign Roc Nation, and that's when it wasn't just like Roc Nation was the only opportunity. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
I went up to
had him in the frenzy, huh?
Yeah, I went up to Atlantic.
Options.
QC was trying hard at me. When I went up to Atlantic, they seen my box. They didn't even really want to deal with me, you know what I'm saying?
So, like, Kodak Black, that's Kodak Black.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? They ain't really want to deal with me.
Pulled out the laundry list and shit.
It's all good. It's all good.
Yeah, I still. Shout out to them though, cause they
Quincy,
still like shout out
you
to
your government
like,
and shit.
Shout out to Dallas. They good folks over there.
And they signed Rico Nasty, so they see what's going on.
Yeah, shout out to Dallas and them. They good folks over there. They still gave me opportunity. You know what I'm saying? But it's just like Roc Nation. That's where it was at. They want to see a nigga win. Yeah.
I mean, if you sit there, and I'll tell, because I see now there's this whole narrative out there from a lot of people about not signing and all that. I'm like, all right, that's great, but that's coming from a, you know.
I mean, that's where you got to have a good.
It's about options, though. You got to look at everything from a business standpoint, sit down.
You got to have a good lawyer.
It makes sense, business sense for you and where you at and your entity and partnering up with a label and do it. You know what I'm saying?
And Q, like, Jay-Z makes good business sense. Let me tell you that.
That's a great partnership.
If that shit don't work out, you got Roc Nation Sports. You got the linebacker, running back body. Look like you can mow some shit down real quick. Yeah, I mean, do you play sports? Like, are you having?
Nothing.
Have you listened to his timeline?
I used to be small as shit. I got big like this from working out when I was locked up. That was it, like doing burpees and shit like that. That's it.
I can't believe you don't play nothing, son.
We play, he on these stages now. That's
trap sports, that's it. Yeah.
Trap sports, you know what I'm saying?
Pull-ups on the stoplights, the light poles and shit like that, that's it.
But musically and movement, the music and the movement now, that's what I like to see, you know what I'm saying? All that.
Yo, we're excited.
Taking all that negativity and channeling it back
out. You really not playing, kid.
It's lit. I'm not playing, man.
Anybody you would like to work with? Just put it out there right now.
It's not nobody I'm really geeking to work with. I mean, I'm down to work with whoever, for real. You know what I'm saying? As long as they real and genuine, they not no weirdos, I'm with it.
It's a few of them floating around, too. I like that he put that out there. Like,
do you listen to disclaimer. Anything like besides your joints, like when you riding around or you on the road?
I listen to like, my man Hollywood YC from Atlanta. I be listening like.
Put us up on. I love that.
He from the A. My man Hollywood. He lit. He a wine. I be listening to a whole lot of stuff. I be listening to Shy. I be listening to like dude from Chicago, Lil Foe. Like young niggas like me. You know
I was about
saying?
To say by the time we hear about them niggas signed, sealed, delivered. Like I just got hot on Lil Baby and this nigga's on fire right now.
Lil Baby lit too.
You know what I mean?
I fuck with Lil Baby. Lil Baby.
I like Lil Baby and shit, but I'm late on that shit. I gotta get ahead of the curve. I think we ahead of the curve this time. Cause I seen Q like one time. Before this, and he stepped out of the smoke-filled studio for a hot minute to say hi, and I appreciated that shit. And I wanted to get back with you ever since. I'm happy for this maturation. Nobody seen this coming. Like for real, we heard you buzzing, but Roc Nation, nigga, like Roc Nation, nigga. Like Roc Nation. Nah, anybody that say that, nah. I don't know. Stu, you see the cover, Stu?
I mean, nah. I
knew somebody was gonna snatch the kid up, but
yeah, definitely.
I ain't know Jay was, you know.
You see that? That's what you know. You
and let me tell you, like, that shit does come from Jay. Like off the no bullshit. Like if you know Jay, there's A&Rs, there's niggas floating around. Zay, I'm sure had a great. You know, influence on it. But ultimately, the nigga's like Oprah. He signs all the checks.
Yeah,
like, oh, we're going to do that? Well, okay,
Shout out my man, E.B., Earl Johnson over there, Benny Pugh.
Yeah, shout out Benny Pugh, my man Orlando.
Oh, my God, Benny. Oh,
good man.
Yeah, Benny running the mule. He president. He OG over there.
Yeah, Benny, the one who I... played the music to and he was
Benny
excited.
Got me a radio,
you know what I'm saying? Yeah. I messed with Benny.
Yeah,
for real.
Benny got me a Power 105.1. That nigga put the cosign in. Yeah. You in. That's it.
That's the OG, triple OG. And Pec Eyes on the sports side, but you know.
Love Pec Eyes. You know that's my guy. Yeah. I got a story time for Pecos, but that's another show right now. Right now, we're going to wrap up. Cue the Fool. Thank you so much, baby. You're not that much of a fool, but I want you to act a motherfucking fool in this industry with this DMV shit, yeah. Okay?
Gang.
I do give you the green light to do that, all right? Please.
Yeah, of course.
You know what I mean? Throw me in the verse, too.
Yeah, I got you.
It's Cue the Fool right here. Hard hats and hot heels, the podcast, baby. We out.